ओके, अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज द मॉलिक्यूलर बेसिस ऑफ द इन्फेक्शन. एज यू नो वी आर स्टडीइंग द चैप्टर नंबर वन ऑफ द पेपर नंबर वन, दैट इज द माइक्रोबायोलॉजी एंड द प्लांट पैथोलॉजी. नाउ अंडर दिस स्पेसिफिक यूनिट यू हैव टू स्टडी द मॉलिक्यूलर बेसिस ऑफ इन्फेक्शन, दैट हाउ इन्फेक्शन ऑकर एट द मॉलिक्यूलर लेवल. ओके, नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडीड द फंगाई इन्फेक्शंस, राइट, बैक्टीरियल इन्फेक्शंस, देन द वायरल इन्फेक्शंस, then the infection which is caused by the nematodes, infection which are caused by the mycoplasma, etc. Okay, so all these infections and their molecular basis of infection we have to study. Okay, actually what happened at the molecular level, what happened exactly at the molecules level, that too you have to understand from the UPSC mains examination point of view. Now, as you know, this topic is quite a long topic, and it can be divided into the many subtopics, and hence the very first subtopic we are going to study is the attachment of pathogen to the host. Okay, how the pathogen attached to the host at a first place, from where the infection actually starts, how the disease-causing bacteria, disease-causing fungi is able to attach itself to the host organism. This will be the very, very important in starting off your answer during the explanation of the molecular basis of infection. Okay, so here we should understand what is pathogen, okay, from where it is coming and how it is going to attach to the specific host, okay, and how they find their own specific host for the infection. The first slide, see, the pathogens such as the molecules or the fastidious bacteria are the protozoa, and most of the viruses are placed directly onto the cells of the plant by their vectors. Now see, majority of the time all of these has their specific vectors. You know, when the flies, they fly from one plant to another plant, they can indirectly take the one pathogen from one place and they can land it on the specific plant surfaces. So vectors are play a major role when transferring the disease causing pathogens from one place to another place or from one plant to the another plant. Okay, when we say how they transfer, because these are bacteria or the protozoa or the other disease causing bacteria viruses are do not have the ability to specifically travel by itself and reach to the plant where the infection is going to occur, but they always require the vectors. Okay, so some kind or other kind of a vector is always involved there when there is a transmission of the infectious pathogen to the plant. Okay, it will not occur directly, or it will not occur on the own of the viruses or the bacteria. Specifically, there should be some kind of a vector which is taking these viruses or the bacteria or the fungi from one place to their plant on which they are going to infect that particular plant species. Okay, so vector play a very, very important role in transmission of the pathogens to the host plant. Now see, however, in almost all fungi, bacteria and the parasitic higher plants are first brought into contact with the external surface of a plant organs. Okay, so basically, although if there are the vectors are there to transfer these pathogenic organisms to the plant, but when they come in a contact with the plant, they come in a contact with the plant of their external surface, okay, not to the internal surface. Now this is very important. If the plant is not injured, okay, if it is not injured, and hence the pathogen cannot directly enter into the body of a plant. So here one thing you have to remember, there can be the two conditions. The very first condition, the plant may be injured, okay, and in that case the pathogen can have a direct entry inside the body of a plant. But if the plant is healthy, it will directly land on the external surface only. Okay, so here although there are the vectors, but they will always land the pathogen on the external surface of the plant body, and from here their efforts to enter into the internally into the plant body will begin. Okay, so the very first contact between the any pathogen with that of their host is their external surface and not the internal surface. Of course, exceptions are there if the plants are injured. Okay, in case if the plant are injured, it is very easy to get inside into the plant. Okay, because then the tissues are break open, and this will facilitate the very easy entry of a pathogen into the internal organs of the plant. Okay, but if the plant is healthy, then of course there are vectors, and vectors will take these pathogens to the external surface of a plant only. Now before they can penetrate and colonize the host, they must first become attached to the host surface. Okay, now this is also very, very important, to be get attached with the host surface. Okay, this thing is also not very easy, that we know vectors are taking the pathogens to the plant surface. Okay, but you know there are many abiotic factors like a wind, water, okay, temperature, many factors are there which can interfere the attachment of the pathogen with that of the host. Because many of the plants as well, they were having the hydrophobic surfaces. Okay, in that case the water will also not work. So attachment to the host surface by the pathogen. It's an important step of the infection, which will rightly start the infectious procedure from there. Okay, but it is not very easy to get attached to the host surface. Okay, although there are facilitating vectors are there which are taking these pathogens to the host plant, but still attaching to the externally to the host plant, that is also not very easy for the pathogen. Okay, so what they do after they got attached with the host surface? Okay, now consider the spores of these pathogens have on their surface or at their tips a mucilaginous substance consisting of a mixture of water, then the insoluble polysaccharides, glycoproteins, lipids, and a fibrillar material. Now, what this particular material or the fluid do? See, which when moistened becomes sticky to help the pathogens to adhere itself to the plant surface. So, how these particular pathogens are able to remain attached with that of the plant surface? Now, as you can see here, how the pathogen is infecting the external surface of a plant, and it is already present within the internal body structures as well. But at the first place, when the vectors are transferring the pathogens to the host, how they are able to attach themselves to the host surface? It is because of the majority of them contains the mucilaginous substances. Okay, what do they have? These spores have the mucilaginous substances, and these mucilaginous substances is nothing but the mixture of water is there within this mucilaginous substance, then insoluble polysaccharides are there, right? Glycoproteins are there, then lipids are there, and the fibrillar material is also there. So the mixture of all this creates the very emulsion of the sticky substance. So these sticky substance, when it melt, it will help the pathogen to get firmly attached with that of the host surface. So this primary requirement is there within the majority of the pathogens which contain this sticky material, which will make them able to get attached with the plant surface. Now, you know till this point that at the first place, the very starting of it, the vectors are required to be get transferred from the one place to the another place and where they can find the suitable host. Then secondly, they must attach to the external surface of the plant. And how they do that? It is due to the mucilaginous sap. Okay, mucilaginous sap is there. This mucilaginous sap will help the pathogen to get itself attached with that of the host surface. Okay, now consider, in some fungi, the hydration of the spore by the moist air causes the extrusion of the preformed mucilage at the tip of the spore that serve as immediate adherence to the hydrophobic plant surfaces. Now see, these fungi possess some special abilities. Now once they were consider here, this is the hydrophobic surface. As you know, the water repelling properties are there within this plant. Okay, so you can say the water repelling plant are more resistant to the fungal infection because there will not be any entertainment of the mucilaginous sap here, because here the plant body itself will repel the liquid material. Okay, but in that case, see, majority of the fungi or some of the fungi, what they do, these fungi are after a hydration from the air. Okay, remember the abiotic factor playing a very major role, that is water in the form of rain or water in the form of moistened air. When it come in contact with the fungi spores, what they do? The preformed mucilage at the tip of a spore will serve as the immediate adherence to the hydrophobic plant surface. Here, when the spore of the fungi, it came in a contact with the moistened air, okay, that is the air which contains the water, it will start protruding its mucilaginous sap, and due to this mucilaginous sap, they will able to attach themselves even the plant if it is hydrophobic in nature. Okay, that is the plant, if the plant is possessing the water repelling properties, still it will not work, because this fungus spore contains the very typical sap, mucilaginous sap. When it comes in a contact with the air, it will become more and more sticky. Okay, if the moistened air is come in contact with these spores, this will create the mucilaginous sap at the tip of the spore, and this mucilaginous sap will stickily or firmly attach to the plant surface even if the plant surface is a hydrophobic in nature. Okay, now consider, however, in some like the powdery mildew fungi which do not require the free water for the infection, adhesion is accomplished by the release of the enzyme cutinase. So you can say from fungi to fungi it will change. Okay, in some fungi the water is a requirement to get moistened and create the spore which has the mucilaginous sap, and they can attach with the plant surface with the help of this mucilaginous sap. But there are some fungi like the powdery mildew fungi, now these do not require the water for their infection. Okay, no moisture is required. So what they do? Once they come in contact with the host surface, what they release is the enzyme cutinase, and this cutinase enzyme will make these fungal spore very able to get attached with the plant surface. right? Which makes the plants and the spore areas attachment more hydrophilic and cement the spores with the plant surface. So it will act in both the ways. It will firstly moisten the spore, and at the same time the plant surface is also got moist in such a way that both will get attached firmly with each other. They can cement this particular area and they can bind these spores with that of the plant. So enzyme cutinase plays a very, very important role in attaching the powdery mildew fungi with that of their host plant. So from the beginning we are saying the vectors are coming into the picture when there is a transmission of the pathogen with that of the host plant. Then secondly, how these particular pathogens are able to get attached with the host plant. The primary reason we have given is the mucilaginous sap, which is present at the tip of the spore, which is sticky in nature. But then there is a second category of a fungi which can even produce the enzymes like the cutinase, okay, very, very important enzyme, which is called as the cutinase, which is produced by the spores. And this cutinase will immediately help the spore to get attached with that of the plant external surface. So both the surfaces of the spores and that of the plant become hydrophilic once there is a release of the cutinase enzyme. Okay, so cutinase enzyme will be very, very important from the UPSC mains examination point of view, that you should mention at the beginning of the infection when the particular fungi came in contact with the host surface, there is an attachment between the two. Okay, and this attachment is often facilitated by the two factors. Which are these two factors? The very first is the mucilaginous fluid or mucilaginous sap, and second factor is the enzyme like cutinase, which will facilitate the attachment of both the surfaces. Okay, so that is why it becomes very, very easy for a fungi to get to infect their host plant, because they can simply travel by the host, or they can simply travel by the vector, or they can simply travel by the air and attach themselves to the host plant, and immediately they will start to secrete the cutinase, and hence they get firmly attached with that of their host plant. Or they, even some fungi can have the mucilaginous sap, which are upon hydration will attach to the host plant. Okay, these are two basic reasons are there why fungi are very efficient in causing the disease into the various plants. Now in other cases, what will happen? See, the propagules or the spore adhesion will require on-spot synthesis of the new glycoproteins, and it may not reach the maximum levels until the 30 minutes after the contact. Now see, this is the third way. Okay, the very first way we have seen is the creation of the mucilaginous sap. Okay, what they create? They create the mucilaginous sap. And after creating the mucilaginous sap, they will be able to attach with that of the host surface. Secondly, they can produce the cutinase enzyme, which will make the spore surface as well as the plant surface hydrophilic, and hence they can facilitate the attachment. Or in a third case, they, after the attachment to the plant surface, they can create the new glycoproteins. Okay, this word is also very important. These glycoproteins, when created, will facilitate the attachment of the spores with that of the host surface. But this may take up to the 30 minutes to create the complete glycoproteins. Okay, so that means for 30 minutes the spore has to attach themselves with that of the host plant on their own. Okay, so if spores are landed on the plant and they get the 30 minutes. In these 30 minutes, they can create the various types of the glycoproteins. And once they create these type of the glycoproteins, these glycoproteins will facilitate the attachment of the spores, infectious spores, with that of the host cell surface. Okay. So the very first method they follow is the production of the mucilaginous sap. Then the second method they follow is the production of cutinase-like enzyme. And the third method is the production of the glycoproteins, okay, which should get created within 30 minutes of the contact. And after their creation, they will efficiently attach to their host, right? Now, in some fungi which are causing the vascular wilts, okay, these spores fails to adhere to after the hydration, but become adhesive after they allow to respire and synthesize the new protein. Okay, this is very similar with the earlier point. Yeah, that is hydration. If the hydration is not working for the attachment, then if they have some time or they remain on the plant surface for a sufficient amount of time, then they can respire and synthesize the new proteins, and these new proteins can create the attachment facilitation on the host surface. Okay, so that means if the first two methods are not working, then the new types of the proteins or new types of the glycoproteins can be created for the attachment of the infectious agent with that of the plant host. Okay, so it will depend all of the fungi, or which type of fungi we are talking about. Depending upon that, these methods will change. Okay, it may be from the first method, second method, third method, or the fourth method. Okay, anything can be there depending upon which fungal species we are talking about. Okay, now consider, see, in many cases, the act of attachment is seems to be necessary for the subsequent transmission of the signal to form the germ tube extension and the production of infectious structure. Okay, so once if considered this is a leaf and the spores are landed on this infectious on this host plant leaf. Okay, but now if they are able to produce the mucilaginous sap, they will attach themselves. If they are able to produce the enzyme cutinase, they will attach to the surface. If they are able to produce the glycoprotein, still they can attach. And if they are stay there for some time and produce their own proteins, they can still stick to the host plant. Now, this will be the starting point of the infection. From here, rightly from here, the infection will start. And after that, there is a after some signaling at the chemical level, there will be the formation of a germ tube. Okay, as you can see in this picture, see how the germ tube is created are there. Okay, see how the germ tubes are running everywhere internally within the plant body. Okay, so after some signaling, then there will be the formation of a germ tube. And as you know, when the germ tube is created, this germ tube will literally enter inside the plant. Okay, so basically here, right from the original place of the pathogen, when they travel to the host plant by using the vectors, okay, they may be the abiotic vectors as well, biotic vectors as well. And when they landed on the plant, these are four possibilities are there to get infect this particular host plant. And after the infection, the next step will be the formation of the germ tube. Okay, and after the formation of germ tube, the real infection starts from here. But it will always starting from the position of a pathogen, which is at a very first place. Okay, so pathogen will travel to the host by using these four methods. It can attach itself to the host, and then after the appropriate chemical signaling, there will be the formation of a germ tube, which will internally infect the plant surface. Okay, now see, in many proteins of the fungal cell wall, okay, as you know, we are talking about the fungal cell, and fungus have their own cell wall. Okay, see here outside, the fungus have their own cell wall, and it is a eukaryotic cell, you know that, right? So these are cell wall, the many proteins which are present within these fungal cell wall, in addition to their structural role, plays the very important role in the adhesion of the fungi. So whatever the proteins which are present in the external cell wall, these are protein will play a very, very important role in attachment with that of the host surface, as we have seen in the fourth possibility, that they will use their own protein. Okay, they will synthesize the protein of the cell wall, and these proteins then will facilitate the attachment of the fungi with that of the host. Okay, so once they got attached with the help of any four possibilities, they will start to create the germ tube, which will later internally infect the plant. Okay, now see, as well as the host surface perception by the fungi. So here the proteins, whatever the proteins which are present in the cell wall of the fungus, these cell wall contains the protein, and these proteins will able to detect the specific host, okay, whether this host is there for this fungus or not. This perception is also done by the proteins which are present in the cell wall of the fungi, and these proteins can also be used for the attachment to the host surface of the plant. Okay, so you can understand that how the pathogen will travel from one place to the host plant, and how they will get attached themselves with that of the host plant. And after that, the next step is to creation the germ tube. So this is all about this topic. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. Please like this video, share this video with your friends who are studying the botany. And if you haven't subscribed to the Botany Obsession channel yet, please subscribe to the Botany Obsession channel for UPSC examination. Again, thank you very much for giving your time. See you in the next video lecture. Thank you.